Inquisitor.
You were made tranquil?
Yes, I am tranquil. It was necessary due to a willful nature that made wielding magic a dangerous endeavor. I remember that being a difficult time, but I cannot remember why. My skills are well used in my current position.
How can you serve the Inquisition?
I am to aid in the research of all creatures encountered in your efforts as leader of the Inquisition.
What makes you particularly qualified?
I remember being fond of animals. I don't remember why.
What is your evaluation of how we're doing?
Adequate, based on a partial improvement to Skyhold.
Here we are again.
I'd like to ask you about Tevinter.
Popular topic. Anything specific?
Anyone who talks about the Imperium mentions slavery. It's the center of the slave trade.
Ah. That is true.
And did you have slaves?
Not personally, but my family does and treats them well. Honestly, I never thought much about it until I came south. Back home, it's how it is. Slaves are everywhere. You don't question it. I'm not even certain many slaves do.
You think slaves like it that way? Don't be ridiculous.
I didn't say they like it. It's all most of them know. In the south, you have alienages, slums, both human and elven. The desperate have no way out. Back home, a poor man can sell himself. As a slave, he could have a position of respect, comfort, and could even support a family. Some slaves are treated poorly, it's true. But do you honestly think inescapable poverty is better?
Is that what you call it? Treated poorly?
Abuse heaped upon those without power isn't limited to Tevinter, my friend. I don't know what it's like to be a slave, true. I never thought about it until I saw how different it was here. But I suspect you don't know either. Nor should you believe that every tale of Tevinter excess is the norm.
It seems strange that an entire empire would be ruled by mages.
I find it strange that your mages don't rule anything at all. Actually, the fiction in the Imperium is that mages don't rule. The Magisterium rules. That magisters are all mages is considered a convenient technicality.
If it's a fiction, that means mages do rule, then.
Yes and no. Let me put it this way. Mages do rule, but not all mages are equal. If you're not from the right family, chances are you don't rule anything. Maybe you're even a slave. The idea that anyone could be a mage, however, keeps the masses placated.
Can anyone be a mage?
Technically. The potential runs mostly in bloodlines, but it's been known to happen. More importantly, commoners believe it can. Tevinter legend is chock full of mage heroes from humble origins. So they hold out hope. Someday my son or my son's son will be a mage. Someday. Poor sods don't realize that means he'll be a quaestor at the arse end of the 100 pillars, at best.
Being a quaestor isn't a good thing?
I imagine the average non-mage likes to think so. Counting numbers and shuffling papers all day is better than many occupations after all. If you're a second-class citizen among a pack of piranha, however, your outlook changes.
I thought the Archon ruled over the Imperium.
Well, yes. Technically, he can overrule laws passed by the Magisterium, but that never happens. Even so, he gets to appoint new magisters, which means all the families vie madly for his favor. Thus, the Archon gets invited to all the parties. The truest path to Tevinter influence, let me tell you.
What is the Magisterium, exactly?
The upper house of the Imperial Senate, and the only part worth having a seat on. Those seats are split among the circles of Magi, the Chantry, and the Major families. All Majors now. It's odd that outside the Imperium, you use Magister like it applies to every Tevinter Mage.
If you're not a Magister, then what are you called? No special title?
I'm an Altus, which is almost as good as a Magister, depending on who you ask.
I've never heard of an Altus.
Upper class. Those families who trace descent from the Dreamers, the first prophets of the old gods. If you're a mage and you're not Altus, then you're later. Lower class. If you're not a mage at all, you're Soperati. That's everyone else. We do love our fancy words.
Service, my lord.
Anything I should know?
Having the Templars join the Inquisition has done wonders for our reputation. The people trust the Templars, and now they trust us.
I'll leave you to your work.
Something wrong with your tea?
It is tea. I detest this stuff. But this morning, I need to shake the dreams from my mind. I may also need a favor.
But you don't need anything from anyone. You're known for that.
One of my oldest friends has been captured by mages, forced into slavery. I heard the cry for help as I slept.
I thought you didn't have any friends besides spirits.
I don't.
So who is this?
My friend is a spirit of wisdom. Unlike the spirits clamoring to enter our world through the rifts, it was dwelling quite happily in the Fade. It was summoned against its will, and wants my help to gain its freedom and return to the Fade.
I thought spirits wanted to find their way into this world.
Some do, certainly. Just as many Orlesian peasants wish they could journey to exotic Ravain. But not everyone wants to go to Ravain. My friend is an explorer, seeking lost wisdom and reflecting it. It would happily discuss philosophy with you, but it had no wish to come here physically.
Do you have any idea what the mages want with your friend?
No. It knows a great deal of lore and history, but a mage could learn that simply by speaking to it in the Fade. It is possible that they seek information it does not wish to give, and intend to torture it.
I've got enough to worry about trying to help real people, Solas.
Of course. I will at least mark it on our map so your forces can avoid the area. Hopefully I'll be able to help it when this is over.
Was there something you needed?
I'd like to know more about the Templars.
What would you like to know?
Do the Templars do anything besides hunt mages?
Templars protect against the dangers of magic. Before the Order left the Chantry, that meant serving in a circle. They were also tasked with tracking apostates, or fighting demons inevitably summoned by the weak or malicious.
What do you think of mages? Are they all a threat?
I've seen the suffering magic can inflict. I've treated mages with distrust because of it, at times without cause. That was unworthy of me. I will try not to do so here. Not that I want mages moving through our base completely unchecked. We need safeguards in place to protect people, including mages, from possession at the least.
Why did you join the Order?
I could think of no better calling than to protect those in need. I used to beg the Templars at our local chantry to teach me. At first, they merely humored me, but I must have shown promise, or at least a willingness to learn. The Knight Captain spoke to my parents on my behalf. They agreed to send me for training. I was 13 when I left home.
13? That's still so young.
I wasn't the youngest there. Some children are promised to the Order at infancy. Still, I didn't take on full responsibilities until I was 18. The Order sees you trained and educated first.
What about your family? Did you miss them?
Of course. But there were many my age who felt the same. We learned to look out for one another.
That's all I wanted to know. Thank you.
I'm sure you have other matters to attend.
Thank you.
Let us begin.
Right.
Inquisitor.
Greetings to you. Never be on our way.
Thank you for this, Inquisitor. We are not far from where my friend was summoned. the mages. Killed by arrows, it could seem.
Killed by arrows? Helpful, yeah? Probably bandits or something.
These aren't mages. The bodies are burned, and these claw marks. No. No, no, no.
Wisdom spirit, my ass.
That is not its natural form. It's been corrupted.
Corrupted?
Forced to act against its original purpose. What did they do? What did they do? What did they do? Perhaps we should ask.
A mage! You're not with the bandits? Do you have any lyrium potions? Most of us are exhausted. We've been fighting that demon.
You summoned that demon! Except it was a spirit of wisdom at the time. You made it kill! You twisted it against its purpose!
I understand how it might be confusing to someone who has not studied demons, but after you help us, I can...
We are not here to help you!
We came to help your friend. Any way to do that now that it's a demon?
You cannot befriend a demon. However amicable it might appear, it must...
Shut up! You summoned it to protect you from the bandits.
I... Yes.
You bound it to obedience, then commanded it to kill. That is when it turned. The summoning circle. We break it, we break the binding. No orders to kill, no conflict with its nature, no demon.
What? The binding is the only thing keeping the demon from killing us. Whatever it was before, it is a monster now.
Inquisitor, please!
Breaking that circle has to be easier than fighting a damn demon.
The summoning circle is part of the demon's current nature. It will certainly attack us as we attempt to break it.
Of course it will.
We must hurry!
Bye. El Arbolos en Asel Atalim. Mamilava Halani. Malasuladin Nadas. Magilani Midanam.
Manuvinin. Dareth Shura.
Come on. There's nothing here for you.
No, there is not. Not anymore. All that remains now is them.
Thank you. We would not have risked a summoning, but the roads are too dangerous to travel unprotected.
You tortured and killed my friend.
We didn't know. It was just the spirit. The book said it could help us.
Solas.
Never again. I need some time alone. I will meet you back at Skyhold.